Kevin here from Wholefleet Diagnostics. Today we're going to go through and show you how to use the multi-pin kit that's included in your Jaltest package. This kit allows us to connect to pretty well any data link on any pretty much any manufacturer. In the case that we don't have the proper cable adapter available. So for example, if we were going to hook up to a piece of Caterpillar equipment and we didn't have that JDC 505 or that that JDC 533 adapter from Jaltest in order to connect directly to that diagnostic port, we can go through and use the multi-pins, and then we're kind of not left hanging at that point. So this multi-pin kit is an awesome feature that's included in your Jaltest package from Wholefleet, and I just want to go through and make sure that everybody's on the same page about how to use this feature of the kit. So let's flip over to our software here. In the software, I'm going to use the example of a Toyota forklift, and the reason for that is that the Toyota forklift does not have we don't have an adapter for the Jaltest kit yet for the Toyota forklift. So if you're using the material handling portion of the software here, this is going to be useful for you to go through and kind of walk you through how to make that connection using the multi-pins. So first and foremost, we'll click in on our material handling section of the software. We'll go down to Toyota. We'll bring up, it doesn't matter, 8FGU, sure. We'll go there and we have the opportunity to hook up to this body computer. Now, before we go and form any connection to any piece of equipment or any vehicle, it's nice to just double check what kind of connectors are required. So if I click on the connectors button here, in this case, it's going to show me that, hey, we have to use these multi-pins. And you can see the multi-pin option is selected here. Now, on a Caterpillar, for example, again, if I clicked on the connector button, it would give me the option for direct connection. It would either give me that part number for JDC 533 or JDC 505. And then I could go through and form that connection if I have that actual cable adapter with me. If I don't, I might want to flip over to multi-pins, as you can see here. And this is going to walk us through exactly how to hook up the multi-pins to that diagnostic port on the piece of equipment. So in this case, we're going to look at pin 8 and 9 on the diagnostic connector is what I'm after. So we're going to have to hook up that JDC 213.9. That is the OBD2 connector that's included with your kit. From there, we're going to add the JTP 101. This is the diagnostic multi-pin adapter. That's this guy here. And then from there, I'm going to want to use my JTP 7. So I've got to pick my JTP 7s out of my multi-pin kit here. And then we're going to connect those to the JTP 101. So this is where we need to go through and make sure we have the proper the proper pins on the connector connected to the proper pins on the multi-pin adapter. Okay, so we're going to look first and foremost at your diagnostic connector. So there we've got our Toyota diagnostic connector here, and you can see that the Jaltest software has already indicated pin 8 and 9 is our twisted pair on this particular device. So we're going to flip over to now the pinout diagram for this connector, and you can see we've got 1 at the bottom there, and then we've got 17 up top. So if I follow the numbers here, we're looking at 7, there's 8, there's 9, that would be 10, there's 11. So we're looking for these two here, these two pins right here is where we're going to actually tap in to this data link. So on pin 8, it indicates that we need an A with a JTP 7 from our multi-pin adapter. So if I go down to my JTP 101, you can see A is the blue pin, and then we're gonna have to put that JTP 7 on the blue pin here, and we're gonna connect that up now to pin 8. Okay, now pin 9, it says, which is directly beside it, we're gonna hook up on pin C of our multi-pin adapter, we're going to put yet again another JTP7. We're going to connect that to the gray one. There's C is gray. We're going to put the second JTP7 on there. We're going to go through and connect that now to pin 9 on our diagnostic adapter. Now, in addition to that, this does require us to power up the Jaltest link. So we do need to connect to our power supply here on the JTP101 adapter using either the alligator clamp or the auxiliary in-vehicle cigarette lighter style 12-volt adapter for the for powering up this Jaltest link before we can form a connection. So make sure we have the proper pins connected to the proper colors on the adapter, and then from there we can go through and form our connection. So that's our tutorial on how to use the multi-pin adapter. Again, those adapters are included with your Wholefleet Jaltest diagnostic kit. If you have any questions or you want to see a specific functionality of the Jaltest software, make sure you subscribe, make sure you give us a call or add in the comments below. We'd be happy to make a personalized video for you on how to use your Jaltest diagnostic kit.